Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can implement linear regression model on a particular data set called as marketing.csv, as you can see on my screen currently, using R. We will create a separate version with the help of Python as well in some other video, but let's start here and see how we can implement linear regression model on this particular data set. Before I take you through R part, let me quickly explain you like what exactly we are looking from here. So as you can see that in the data set, this is a pretty simple data set. We have these many columns over here. So if I have to write the equation of it, ignore the first column that you are having here. That's nothing but the serial number, right? So you can ignore that particular part. And now, this sales value that you have, this is your dependent variable, right? Rest YouTube, Facebook, and newspaper are your independent variables. So if I have to write the equation, linear equation for this, it will be something like, sales is equal to beta naught plus beta one times YouTube plus beta two times it will be Facebook plus beta three times it will be newspaper. Right? So this will be a typical equation. What we need to find is this beta naught, beta one, beta two, and beta three. If we have found this, then you can easily predict the sales value. And that's what we are going to do in this particular exercise as well. Another thing that will be important or interesting to see is, let's consider this example, like, this is this particular sales prediction we are building for a, building for an online store, right? Let's say, and this online store is doing three modes of advertisement currently. They are doing either through YouTube, Facebook, or through the newspaper, right? Now, we want to evaluate out of these three advertisement medium, which one is beneficial for them, right? Or later on, let's say, if they have to terminate one of the advertisement medium, probably what it can be, right? So we have to deal with all of these. So now let's start and work on implementation of this particular marketing.csv dataset to predict sales value in R. I'll share the link of this particular dataset. You can find it in the description box. So let's quickly go ahead and load the dataset. Multiple ways to load the dataset. I'll use this import dataset technique from here. I'll select this text base, as I'm having a CSV file, and it will be very easy to go ahead with it, right? Before that, I just, I'll just close the opened file here. So as you can see, I have just selected the data set. The name is default marketing, right? Row name is automatic, separator is comma, and rest of the things looks good. I have selected header is equal to true, right? And so the data looks like this. The first column doesn't have any header. So you can see X have been written over here, right? I'll just click on import, and the data set has been imported now, right? So this is exactly your data set, which is around 200 records are there, with the total five columns are there, right? Now, let's quickly look at the headers of this data set. So to check the header, I can use ls function. So ls of my data set name is marketing. So you can see these are the headers of it. We have columns like Facebook, newspaper, sales, X, and YouTube, where X is something we will drop, right? Sales is your dependent variable. YouTube, Facebook, and newspaper are your independent variables, right? So based upon the YouTube, newspaper, and sales, we will figure out, how much sales that offline store is going to generate. Okay, let's quickly also look at the structure of this data set. So for that, I can use simply a structure of marketing, right? And this is how it is. It's a data frame with 200 observations and five variables. And, it seems like we have pretty good data, data types. Like all the relevant columns are in numerical, and that makes sense as well. So probably nothing much we have to check over here. Let's quickly check for the null values as well, right? So to check the null value, we can either use call sums, or simply sum all as well. I'm using call sum, so it will show me the the null values corresponding to the different columns. So call sums of marketing. So you can see we don't have any null record over here. So I think we are good in this part as well. Let's also look at, let's plot sales with YouTube, Facebook, and newspaper to see how, the relationship look like. As you know, we have certain assumptions for a data set to be considered as a linear regression model, right? So let's quickly look at it. So what I'm going to do is I'll quickly create a plot, right? And in this plot, I'll use like marketing dollar sales to access the dependent variable, and then marketing dollar, let's first try with YouTube, right? And I'll just put color equal to, I'll select three colors from rainbow. Okay, let's quickly look at it, how it look like. So you can see this is how it's look like, right? So this is pretty much a kind of, positive linear regression, right? So if you look at the graph, it's pretty much the linear regression. Similarly, and that's a positive one, right? Similarly, let's put up for, the other independent variables like Facebook and newspaper as well. So I'll quickly copy paste over here. So this is for Facebook. Let me execute this. Okay, this is also kind of positive only, but this is highly scattered, right? And then finally, let's look at newspaper. So let me copy this line, put over here, and here I will make newspaper. And let's look at it. Okay, so this is how newspaper looks like, right? It's not following a particular pattern, right? It's highly scattered it is, right? But it seems like newspaper might even give you not so good result as well. Let's see how it goes. You can also look at box plot to see, do we have any outliers in this or not? So this is how the box plot look like. If I'll zoom this particular, so we are having, YouTube is pretty clean, Facebook is clean. In newspaper, we are having two upper outlier, right? And sales is pretty clean. So one option is like, you can go ahead, remove the outliers, or, you can replace the outliers with median values, or probably you can go ahead, right, and see whether newspaper is really a relevant variable or not, right? Cool. Okay. So till this part, we have explored the data and data looks to be in good shape. Now, what we will do is we'll convert the data set into test and train. And for that, I'll quickly import a library called as CA Tools. If you haven't installed this, you need to first install this particular library as well, right? This particular package as well. For me, it's already been installed, so I have quickly initialized over here. Now, I am defining set.seed for some value, let's say, 100, right? So that it will maintain the randomness state. And now I'll quickly convert the data set into precision train, right? If you look at the data set, right? Marketing data set, we had somewhere around, I think, 200 record, right? So let's quickly do 25-75 conversion we can consider, like 25% in the testing data set and 75% in the training data set. So what I'm going to do is I'll quickly create a variable called as sample. Sample will be sample dot split. I'm splitting the marketing data set, and I'll select the split ratio as 0.75. And we'll have the sample record in my training data set and remaining record in my testing data set. How? This way. Train will be equal to subset of marketing, right? And here I can do sample equal to true. That basically means, right? That 75% record will be in the training data set. Oops, not info. I was looking at head. Yeah. So this is how the data look like. Definitely X you can remove anytime. It's not required. And ultimately while going through the, the model, maybe I can drop there as well. So up to you how you consider this, right? If I look at a structure of train, that should be pretty much, right? 120 observation of 5 different variables. Okay. Now, similarly, I can create test. So test will be equal to the same thing. I'll just select where sample is equal to false, right? So that will be basically your 25% of the data. So if I'll do a structure of test, that should be around 80 records with 5 different variables, right? So this way, we have pretty much splitted the data set into test and train. right? Now, the next step is to create the model. So create the model. How? Let's say my model name is M1. So M1 will be equal to, LM is the function for linear regression. Your dependent variable, which is sales, an exotic mark I'm putting here. And then I'll just write, you know, our independent variables. Those are like YouTube plus Facebook plus newspaper, right? And then I'll say data equal to train, as we will be building the model on the training data set. Oops. Right. So this particular model has been created. Let's quickly analyze the model. So for that, I'll use summary of M1. And this will give you pretty good amount of information for you. Let's start analyzing all the information one by one. So the first line that you are seeing here, this is nothing but your formula that you have written, that we have written. This is your residual values, right? So residuals would be like, you know, difference between actual and predicted. And this is the statistical distribution of it. Then we have coefficient. So this is the value of beta naught. Then the coefficient of YouTube is 0.04. Facebook is 0.19 and newspaper is minus, right? This is a standard error around these variables. This is T value. And this is what we have called as P values. One more thing that you can look over here is the star. A star basically talks about the relevancy of it. 3-star basically means like, you know, these are 100% relevant, right? So you can see here, 3-star means 0, that means 100% relevance. 2-star means 0.001, so 1 minus 0.001 relevance, and so on. So the ideal thing would be anything that has a star, you should consider it. So this is for intercept, so that's okay. These two variables are significant for this model. The last variable, that's newspaper, it's not significant. You can see this over here also, 0.954 it is. So this should ideally be less than 0.05, but this is pretty much higher than 0.05, right? So this is not the relevant variable for us. Another thing that you can see here is the coefficient is negative. That basically means like, if I'll write the equation of sales here, so sales will be equal to 3.08 plus 0.047 times YouTube plus 0.19 times Facebook and minus 0.00045 times newspaper it is. That basically means like, you know, if I have to spend $1,000 in each advertisement system, right? So if I'll do for YouTube, I won't do for Facebook and newspaper, my sales will be 3.08 plus 47, right? 3.08 plus 47. So that will be like around 50 unit of sales we'll be getting. If I'll spend this $1,000 on, let's say, Facebook, right? So sales will be in that case 3.08, right? Plus 190. That basically means like around 190 units of sales we'll be getting. Similarly, if I'll spend that $1,000 on newspaper, that means these two are not there. So sales will be 3.08 minus, right? Some very small amount. So that will be 3 only, right? So you can see, if you are only considering newspaper, right? It's basically decreasing your sales. And that can be proven from here as well. It's not the relevant variable, right? So as this is not the relevant variable, so maybe what we can do now is, we can go ahead, create another model, and in that model, we can, you know, remove the newspaper from there. We have some other details as well, like residual standard error is 2.28 with 160 degrees of freedom, and that makes sense, right? Because total number of record we have considered 120 minus 1 minus 3 for variable, so that's around 116, right? R square is 88.18, that's pretty good. Adjusted R square is 87.88. P value is very small, so it's good. And F statistics value is 288.6. So the parameter looks good for now, right? Now let's go ahead and create another set of the model without newspaper. So I'm just removing the newspaper from here. The rest of the things would be same. Let's call this model as M2, right? And let's see the summary. Okay, so here, you can see now Facebook, YouTube, both are good. Rest of the parameters have not changed a lot. So if I'll have to write the equation of sales, so in that case, sales will be 3.07 plus 0.47 times YouTube plus 0.19 times Facebook. So this will be your final equation, right? You can see one thing is, if I look at the previous R square and this R square, see what happens. Previously, we were getting R square as 88.18. Still, R square is 88.18 only, so not much changes, right? But if you look at adjusted R square, earlier it was 87.88, now it's 87.98. So slightly increase has happened in case of adjusted R square. That basically means like whatever variable we have removed has made a positive impact on your model, right? So this way you can consider like, you know, the whether the model has given you the good result or not. Now, let's work on the prediction. So if I will have to do the prediction, so for that, what I can do is I can write like, you know, let's say pred is my variable name. So pred is equal to, predict is the function name. So predict, I will be predicting on my testing data set. First write my model name, my final model is M2, and then the testing data set, that's test, right? And now if I look at summary of prediction, let's see how it is, right? So this is how the summary looks like. If I look at how the test data, sorry, not test data, I should have looked for prediction, right? So prediction, so this is how prediction look like. Let's quickly take the, you know, the first few records and see how it is. If I'll do head of pred, right, this is how it is. And if I'll do head of test, this is how it is, right? Or better, let's do this way. Let's only select the test dollar cells, say this way, right? Now let's quickly compare it. Although we won't be doing all the comparison manually, but let's understand this. So our actual data set says the first value, sales value is 11.16. The prediction has been 14.58. Second is pretty close, 15.5, 15.7. Third is 15.8, 14.3. Then 12.7, 14.9, 11, 12, 22. Right? So it's a little bit close, but definitely there are differences, right? And those are nothing but your error, right? You can also maybe, you know, combine these two so that you can have this side by side. What I mean to say is, let's create a data frame where you will be having the actual data and the predicted data, right? So let's say data frame name is df. I can use data.frame, right? Here I can use cbind for column binding, right? And then I can have actual is equal to test dollar sales and prediction will be equal to pred, right? And now if I'll use view of df, see how it is, right? So you can see the differences among it. You can also add a column which will be like, you know, the overall differences between each record, but I'm leaving that up to you, right? Now, what we will be doing over here is, we'll find the residual error, you know, residual standard error in this model, so that we'll get an idea of the accuracy. Right? So to find the residual standard error, you can do like this. So we have sigmoid function. So I'll just, sigma function. I'll just use sigma of my model, that's M2, multiplied by 100, right? So this will be like this. And then divide by mean value of your dependent variable. So dependent variable is marketing dollar sales, right? So your residual error is coming around 13.5%. And that's a good value, right? That's a good value. So that's how you can implement linear regression model, simple linear regression model, right? With multiple variables in R. I hope you liked it. If you got any question, feel free to comment and I will be happy to answer. Thank you.